Alright. Logan, can you hear me? Well, might as well dive in. Okay, cool. Yeah, I can't. There's no monitor on these headphones, so I have no idea if my voice is coming through. Excellent. So, thanks for watching, Logan. Hopefully, maybe we'll get some more people. I don't know. But this is the first time the stream has actually worked since we named the show, and since I've been able to really get my schedule cleared up for this. So, in Morning Glory, I try to play about maybe a half hour, maybe 45 minutes worth of games before I have to get ready and go for work. But, yeah, so today we're doing Enter the Gungeon. This is technically really my first time diving into it. I got it last night and got into it a little bit. Really, really fun game. So I don't know which of the four characters are my favorite. I'd love to hear what some of yours are. But I had gravitated toward the pilot immediately, and I think I'm pretty fluent with him, but I immediately fell in love with the hunter. So I'm gonna do a little run with the hunter. I'm so glad to finally be playing this game. It is absolutely incredible, especially after getting into the Battle Royale system on Hyper Light Drifter. This being suggested as like the next game for me to play really was the perfect suggestion. I can't really see my screen very well. Let me turn off some lights. That's better. Alright, so let's dive on in. I'm probably going to be a little rusty because I only played it last night. Oh, that son of a bitch. Yeah, the hunter is great. I feel like I had a very instant connection with the hunter. I am naturally inclined to use ranged weapons. When using guns, I like using the ones that have the broadest reach. Broad is the wrong word. Longest reach. Oh, jeez. But the crossbow is a really nice gun. I think maybe that's the seller for her, is like just, you can just drop these dudes as long as they're not being covered by boxes. Boom. Just kind of run and gun. That's the name of the game, eh? I have to say, this game is incredibly fun. It is incredibly challenging as well. I beat the boss once in my entire playthrough last night. Ooh. Yeah, this game is actually really tricky to play and talk. Love the random generated levels thing can go either way on this one for me. I really think this game could be really fun with a rigid structure too. Yeah, I think this game is especially difficult to stream because of the level of concentration that takes. Like, I would be horrible at streaming shmups as well. I think I think Tommy said it in the Detroit Arcade Club forum that this game is good for me because I like games with a, for some reason, a high risk and low reward. Like, the little reward feels that much more exciting when it's small, when you're given little doses of what's cool. Ooh, this is new to me, the shock rifle. I can only imagine what that does. I'm gonna try my best to not use the ammo nomicon during the stream, just because it's kind of breaks up the gameplay. But I do need to. Ooh, hello. That's pretty. Let's see if I can hit somebody with it. Oops. I guess as kind of funny as it is, as impractical as it is, I should say, I do love the just like it's cool. I do love the just like siphoning through each weapon little by little and just like wrecking dudes. I'm really struggling here to maintain my health. Oh my god. Yeah, I've never run into this many enemies, like, directly. That seems like such a rookie mistake. Yeah, the descriptions are really fun. But, like, even the names of the guns are freaking hilarious half of the time. I can't remember which one I picked up yesterday. It was, something to do with a mermaid. It was really wild. Alright. Hook me up with that money. Oh, so yeah, I think that one of the downsides to having randomly generated levels in a game like this is that part of the fun is unlocking the new stuff, and it... Oops, I just killed myself. Yeah, the rusty sidearm does sound like a drink you would get at a bar in Ypsilanti for sure. Not that Ypsilanti is a dingy town or anything. We're not saying that. Nobody said that. So what should I do here? Maybe I should, change it up. I'll go with the pilot this time. I did like him quite a bit. I got to the boss numerous times. I couldn't beat the boss with him. I think the only time I actually beat the boss was with, the convict, and I didn't really care for her play, her stat boost, or whatever, her innate feats. Pilot, I just like it because it's almost like they just 8-bitified Harrison Ford. I just feel like, oh, it's a little chibi Harrison Ford, running around shooting stuff. Either Han Solo or Indiana Jones, whatever. Or the President in Air Force One. Oh, these dumb little bullet dudes. Oh, Jesus, what did I do that for? Letting these fuckers bunch up, that's not smart. Yeah, lesson learned that you don't let the projectile guys bunch up. I've already been playing for 10 minutes, that seems ridiculous. You know, I'd love to get a nice little extra gun here. Oh, jeez. So if you can, like, team up with people in this game, I think I'd really like that. It'd be a lot of fun. I'm sure the game has some sort of balance. When you have more people, there's probably more enemies or something. Or maybe somebody can chime in. Everything about this game, just like it's perfect for somebody like me. Oh, noodle, you. What was I gonna use that ammo for? I've got, the only gun I have is an infinite ammo pistol. Oh, jeez, where'd the blue dude come from? That is really kind of, that's a bummer. It does seem kind of fun though, because not enough games do that. I think, to anybody who's listening, Logan says, I think co-op is restricted to local and share play, which is kind of janky. Yeah, that's a little frustrating, but I don't think we have enough games that say, hey, if you want to play this with your friends, they have to be there with you hanging out, playing. We don't have, like split screen doesn't exist in games anymore. Like, they still put it into some games, but it's never the selling feature, right? Like, we don't have GoldenEye sessions anymore, and I think the progression of gaming is incredibly normal, natural, and something that we just have to accept, but it is a bummer that we just don't have multiplayer games, like this, I guess, more of them that just really focus on getting you to play with people in the same room as you. Couch co-op is becoming a trend in the same way that vinyl records were a trend. Like, it's not like it's gonna go anywhere, but somebody's always going to be nostalgic enough for it that it's going to exist. It's like an even better example than vinyl is probably photography, like specifically analog photography. Like, that is it's a dated thing, but somebody wants to do it, so we'll always have it. I just wish that there were more fun games that were couch co-op. And being exclusive to that is not necessarily a good thing either. I think that's something you just don't see. God, I'm getting sick of this. What the hell? Oh, not those grenade dudes. They're the worst. Yeah, I think this game, it's gonna take me a while to get used to, like certain enemies are really easy to figure out their bullet spray or their pattern, but like, some of them, like those big grenade dudes, I don't know how big their blast radius is, so one of them hit me, I had no clue. So I'd be curious to see how other people, specifically in Detroit Arcade Club, play this game. I think everybody's going to have a slightly different strategy. I think mine is a little bit more skittish than most people's. Just hiding around the corners of everything. That seems to be like the easy way to handle this. Which direction should I go in? It's like a long hallway. Oh, a little freeze. Whoa, not that dude. Ooh. Should I open it? the Desert Eagle. Dungeon Eagle, sorry. I have come across this gun. I don't know if this is like a common, if it's like a popular route to play this game, but, oh, jeez. The Dungeon Eagle is no better than the standard gun I have. It seems kind of weird. Oh, no. What about the fireplace? Now I'm curious. Like, is there a secret involved? Do I have to go back and screw around with some shit? I don't have anything with ice. Am I supposed to do something? You know, if it does, I didn't notice just there, but maybe I was fighting a more challenging enemy than I thought. Oh, you'll let me figure it out. I don't have any, I'm not gonna risk my last drain of health here. Maybe I should. Alright, let's get one of those. Oh, we're right by the little shop. What up, homie? I feel like I try really hard not to buy things, but this game really makes you want to buy things. What am I supposed to do to make that happen? Oh, dude, I didn't know you could charge the Dungeon Eagle. That's a game changer. I can't imagine what's going on with this fireplace, so, I don't know, maybe I need some item and, you're just, you're being, tricky here. Lack of better word. I don't see anything going on there, so. With the randomness that is this game, I want to say there's, what, probably a fireplace in every dungeon. Not necessarily, but at least relatively common. That's it? That's the whole dungeon? Ah, I knew I missed something. Teleport is a very nice feature in this game. I think of the last night when I played, oh no! Last night when I was playing, I think, I found it kind of odd because just about every room I went in had a teleport module, and I just think that that's kind of strange. Is that strange that, like, you wouldn't need to warp in every single room? You would need one, like, say, in every hotspot, but because it's randomly generated, I'm sure that's a huge part of it. Alright, we're gonna go back to the hunter and maybe. Yeah, you're totally right. I failed to remember the invulnerability rules. Excuse me, the invulnerability rules. Well, yeah, the warp is great, but because of the random. Yeah, that seems logical. Using the warp about 3 or 4 times in each dungeon alone. Yeah, especially like the way that I've been playing this game, the more comfortable I got with it last night, I was straight up running and gunning. If I could dive into a room and just light people up, I absolutely would. I never used those damn things for cover, though. Prostrats. Whoa! 2 of these dudes! What up? Alright. Yeah, dude. I never use these things. They're... As cool as it is, like, the concept is really awesome. It just fails me every time. Look at that. I could have used a little strategy there. Oh, that didn't help. Ah. I probably look ridiculous playing this game. So I gotta ask, do you ever, like, unlock other characters to play as, or do you ever get the option to create your own preset? Because it seems kind of, Oops, dodge away. Why did I do that? Secret characters. You haven't even unlocked them, so you're still running on the same four. They haven't, like, done any DLC or something where you could just get, like, I don't know, bonus characters. It seems like that would be a huge seller, too, is, like, if you go far enough in the game, if you unlock enough guns, that you would actually get to choose, I don't know, with, like, a gun ranking system, you could actually choose, say, like, I don't know, 1 to 3 guns to carry with you, and maybe a power-up, like, I don't know, ideas like that, when I come up with them, they sound great in my head, and then immediately after I think, oh yeah, you know, there's a reason they don't do that. It's, like, part of the fun of the game is the rigid limitation of it. Some of the appeal, of course, the hunter is the dog. Little puppy dog. And in the description, one of my favorite things is that they mention that, you know, he's really good at finding objects in a cleared room. So you get good bonuses for having the dog. But he just can't seem to stick to learning combat at all. He can't learn combat. Cute little dog, can't learn combat. Oh, we got both the shotguns? Nice. Seems like a safe bet. It was not. So, the way this game plays, being so random, and the fact that you never start up with the same stuff again, like, do you earn things, like, long-term things for this game through, like, just getting farther and farther in the Gungeon each time? Like, this game seems about discovering new weapons, but not about actually unlocking things. I've never really experienced that. I think even Downwell, of course, another Devolver title, has that going on, but it's a little bit more excusable, I think, in Downwell's case, because it seems like such a small game. It's only 4 worlds, but... What do we have here? Ooh, alien sidearm. Currency that carries over, like my bullets? Or like a special currency? I'm curious. Maybe don't spoil it if you think it's a spoiler, but I really don't. This game doesn't vibe as, like, a spoiler-type game, like, aside from, apparently, fireplaces, which I will figure out at some point. Ooh, jeez. So, here's something else, is, I don't think I feel like, I think vibration could be a little bit stronger when you get shot. I think I can feel it when the guns fire really well, and I love that feeling, but I don't think that I can feel the... Yeah, so, sorry, I cut off mid-sentence. It's totally unprofessional of me. Yeah, this game does have a ton of secrets. I know I did see secret walls as, like, a thing, but I have no idea where, like, how to access those. I don't know what gun or grenade you need to do that. Yeah. How's it, lack of carryover? It seems kind of crazy. Ooh. I need to test that out more. I didn't realize I could charge my shots. Alright, so instead of screwing around doing this. Oh, I left a chest to be opened. I need a key. One of the benefits of the dog that he finds things is that finding keys, that's huge. Finding items in general is huge in this game, but finding keys? I mean, forget about it. Need those keys. Love unlocking stuff. Ooh, what you got here? Flare gun? T-shirt cannon, I snagged one of those the other day. Keys. Alright. Dang, we're reaching the 30-minute mark. I really don't want to end my gameplay here. Oh, so I get a key out of that? That's kind of funny. Yeah, it's already 10:30. Alright, well, let's start to wind this thing down. Let's get to the boss here. Okay, well, this will be the first time I've actually made it to the boss. Should I buy some health if I can? I guess I probably should. Three freaking things away from it. Dog's not gonna help me find anything else. Oh, let's stick to the pit. Alright, let's do this. Time for the boss. Wish me luck. Oh, I hate this one. I only really fought three bosses total. And the only one I could beat was the bird. And it was pretty much because I had the right equipment. Jesus. I'm getting wrecked, Logan. This is a tough one. I didn't come prepared enough for this battle. Oh, why am I not using that? Ugh. Oh, the hunter must have, like, a saving throw or at the last health you have, like, some bonus. Always be firing. Thank you for the lessons in this game, Logan. It is very much appreciated. You know, I'm going to sneak in one more. I probably shouldn't, but I'm going to do it anyway. And I'm going to use the hunter because this has been a good little run. I love my hunter. And I just fly right through this. Before you guys had told me in our forums that this game was going to be like random levels, I was so upset that this wasn't on beta, and then once I saw the generating load time, I was like, yeah, this is never gonna make it to beta. That's just too intense a game for the tiny little handheld system. As much as I love the damn thing. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, patience pays off in this game too. Yeah, you know, this game does a really good job of emulating that feeling that you see in movies and things that, you know, you want to experience for yourself, but you can't because life. If you were stuck in a position like this, you'd die immediately. We're not equipped to handle this kind of ridiculous action. But we're so used to seeing it, and we, you know, love action movies. But this does a really good job of emulating that feeling that you get. I mean, all it is a dodge roll and firing a gun, but something about it and the animations and everything just makes it feel so satisfying that when you do complete a section or finally kill that one enemy that you've been struggling to figure out the strategy to, it feels so good. Hyper Light Drifter absolutely taught me how to be patient in video games. I'd never really been good about that. I think Mega Man is another good example of a game that taught me patience in gaming, but it never really stuck until recently how patient I can be and how much more successful I'll be through that patience. But yeah, this game is so much fun. I really think like games like this should be suggested to people that are picking up new PlayStation 4, Xbox One, whatever. Indie games really should be part of like that. I think that opening package, because a game like this has infinite replay value, and what they're producing and what they're giving you are AAA titles. I don't think really. I mean, they give you a story. I don't want to say that they're not good games, but they give you a story and you can beat the game, say like 20 to 50 hours, and then that's it, then you're done. It's like, this game, if you got this with like a PlayStation 4 right off the bat, you could be playing that PlayStation 4 for a while without. Yeah, it's like a little starter pack. I think the reason they wouldn't do it is market reasons. You don't want to encourage people to not. You don't want to encourage people to not buy more games. You want them to spend as much money as possible right off the bat, but I always like to think that maybe they can be courteous to their fans a little bit more. Not that they're particularly discourteous. Oh, I'm starting to trail off, guys. I'm sorry. This early part of the day for me, but this is helping me get a little bit more rigid about the way I handle playing video games. Trying not to play for more than like an hour or so at a time, which is very difficult. If I start playing, I'm losing my train of thought trying to fight these guys. I don't even remember what I'm talking about anymore. It's been a long morning. Long morning of Gungeon. This game is great, though. I would probably be streaming this quite a bit more. Hopefully not annoyingly, but games like this, I don't let go of very easily. And like Hyper Light Drifter, I can only play so much of that without boring you guys. This is a game that you guys don't even need to hear me talking. In fact, you'd probably prefer it if I wasn't talking. Sometimes I would prefer it if I wasn't talking. Alright, let's go get this other thing. This is another thing I'm curious about. I haven't looked at any instruction manual stuff about this game aside from, you know, a few item descriptions and things, but I guess this does kind of solve my question of, do the chests, the look of the chest, does that determine what's going to be inside of the chest? And it seems like no. Because that was a gun and the other one was a power-up, and I still probably have some money left. Oh, I've got 8 bullets. I'm gonna get some with that. There are tears. Oh, so they... Okay. The quality. Okay. Well, that makes sense. That's why I kind of skipped over the brown wooden... chest last time in favor of possibly finding a stone one, or I don't know what the hell, I just opened an emerald one. Yeah, brown chest is totally true. Well, yeah, brown chester. So those are my two extremes. Ooh, I love this one. I love spray bullets. Oh, you rotten bastards. Toast. Shouldn't be getting that close. Ah. Yeah, I just wanted to kill one of them. I was so close, I've never gotten that close. Oh, what up, Greg? Thanks for joining in. Unfortunately, that was probably going to be my last run in the Gungeon here. Because I do have to get ready for work. You guys are already at work. I don't know if that makes you lucky or what. Let's return to the breach. So that was my first official stream of Gungeon. I played maybe about an hour yesterday. So much fun. Oh, this game. And now I have like this great adrenaline rush. Like, what's going on here in the center? I didn't see that thing before. What are you all about? So nothing can be done with this? It's just like a weird blue orb. Okay. We're just hanging out in the battle lounge. Yeah, I'm very curious about these extra characters. I'm also very curious about I don't get the hell. Yeah, it doesn't make sense. It's probably like a Star Wars reference. Yeah, I'm super curious about these secrets in the world, particularly the fireplace. I'm gonna try really hard not to look that up. That's gonna be the trick. It's like this game, it would almost be more make more sense for me to look things up, but in certain situations, such as secrets, I'd rather just keep it a secret until I can resolve what the status is. I'm sure there will be plenty of fireplaces. Damn, what's with all these side doors? I only noticed one of them last night. I didn't see all these ones. It's intuitive, but I was thinking like, oh, well, maybe I'm supposed to like hit something and it's gonna open up a secret passageway, but I couldn't find anything. So, I was really low health too at the time, and I didn't really want to risk like, oh, if I get burned by this fire, I could die, and then that ruins my chance at even doing anything. So, I think given another playthrough, I'll probably, you know what? Screw it, guys. We're doing another one. I'm just not gonna post this to my personal Twitter. The two in the top right is my main. Oh, okay. So because I beat one boss, I got a couple of currency. Oh shit! Hit it the wrong way. Gotcha. Yeah, since Greg popped in, I might as well. I don't need the. I actually did quite a bit of stuff earlier today to prevent there being any real issue with me being ready for work in time, which is a running theme in my life, I've noticed. Soldier is a good class, starting class, by the way. Oh, the Marine. Yeah, I played with him very briefly. I didn't care for him, but I don't know. I shouldn't say anything like this, but I want to say that I try to avoid being like a starter player, except in the case of Street Fighter. Because I really only know how to play as Ryu, or the Shoto fighters. What key? Did I miss a key? Son of a. Where did that shotgun dude come from? Alright. Enough of this nonsense. Finally, okay. It's probably gone now. Is it seriously like that? I didn't realize that. I thought RR was the dude who like steals shit. Aha! It's still there. Don't worry, guys. I got the key. Does the rat dude steal keys too? I thought he just stole like weapons. I laid something out once and he just like nabbed it. Oh no, it was I got a power up in place of a Molotov cocktail, and he was like, oh, thanks for the cocktail. I'm sure you guys know this, but like it will tell you on the map if there's an item left in a room. What are all these keys? That nerd eats everything. I love when you see the side that you can't enter from, the doorway that can't be opened, because clearly there's no back entrance to that. Oh, it's a green Necronomicon. what are these guys actually called? Do the enemies, of course, have to have names. Yeah, dude, key rich, but what good's it gonna do me? Go for the shallow one. Damn it. This is why I think this game absolutely needs a melee button, even though it is called Gungeon. I think your character should at least have, like, a knife or something. What the hell am I doing with this? That's seriously a thing that just happened. I just launched an anvil out of a box. Oh, this game's amazing. Alright, let's, alright, there's a little room over here. You guys are probably hating on me for just using the standard bullshit pistol with all these, like, crazy weapons. But, like, this one takes some effort to use. Keep that weapon equipped. Yeah, see, that's what I'm talking about. I'm probably driving you guys crazy. I'm like, I'm an annoying conservationist when it comes to ammunition. I don't like using it. But to the point that it fails me miserably. Okay, let's do some warp. This game is clearly not about conserving anything. It's about, like, as much excess as you can handle. Of course the special guns are so good. I need to... But, like, look at what's going on here. I just let myself get wrecked. Oh, that's satisfying. Little shop time. Oh, cool. I can buy 3 more keys. So, Key Rich, I think, is right. So is that a pun, Logan? Roll with it? Dodge roll with it? This gun is... If I'm lucky, this gun is gonna wreck the boss in this level. Okay. And maybe I'll actually beat another boss. Protect this boss. Alright, so all those keys, hey, there's really nothing. And I stole the key, what the heck? Oh, that was a dumb move. So I actually am a little bummed I didn't get much opportunity to watch the Devolver enter the Gungeon stream, Gungeoneering 101 or whatever. So I didn't really get to see much of like whatever tricks and tips they had to say. It's so difficult for me to watch streams like that while I'm in the middle of my work day. I thought this thing would be far more damage inducing than that. Oh. Wrecked. Yeah, bosses are gonna be probably the hardest thing for me to get the hang of. No matter what their pattern is, I mentioned earlier on the stream that I am terrible at shmups. And bullet hell games in general used to induce some sort of panic in me, but now it's like... after watching Eric play, like, Dodonpachi, he's so talented and has played those games so much that he knows the patterns and the ins and outs, and it's just so cool watching somebody who can just, like, fluidly play a game like that, like, plow through. So I think this, if you're the right player, I think this game could be incredibly fun to watch. Maybe I'll be that player someday. I can be that player. You know, after wanting to have somebody else on the chat with me for the longest time, I'm starting to think that maybe my weird inner monologue would just be a much better thing for people to listen to. The weird things that come out of my head. Oh, look at all these doors. I hate getting stuck in that position. Oh sure, send me more. Cause the three or four that I had at the time weren't enough. What'd you got there? Nothing? Alright. Snowballer, that seems like fun. Devolver. Logan or Greg, if you guys are still there, do either of you know if this is by the same developer as Downwell? Because aesthetically, it shares a lot of similarities, and I didn't take the time to look this morning before we were doing the stream. It's not, really. It's like the pause screen looks almost identical, like art style. Dodge Roll Games, that's the perfect name for, a company like this. This shit all just looks the same. So you think Devolver like goes out of their way to pick games that are just aesthetically super similar? See, swiper no swiping left my health here. One dude in Japan made Downwell. That's awesome. That does seem like a one-man crafted game, though. And freaking awesome at that. Oh, I didn't realize he was using a specialty gun. I think you're actually right. I think it's just the fact that these two are incredibly similar, which is kind of unlike their other games, of course. That's the name of the game, Logan. We gotta drink coffee, talk games. Single action army. I feel like Revolver Ocelot. Oh, and they even made the bullets freaking deflect off the walls. I should have caught that. You can't shoot first? What do you mean though? Oh yeah, well that's what I mean though. Like, I don't have anything with like water or ice or... Oh dude. Don't even tell me. Where was that fireplace, by the way? Where was the fireplace? Am I, like, crazy? Was it in, like, a main room? Oh, man, this is gonna be a little time waster here. 11 o'clock. Alright. I lost track of the freaking thing. I went all the way back to the beginning like a jackass. Yeah, like, what the hell room was I in? Was I all the way at the bottom? No. It's not that important right now. You've ruined this game. I have to know every secret now. And I'm stuck not being able to complete the game because... Okay, well, as you pointed out, it's not important right now. I'll just finish this dungeon. If I can. Is there any way to destroy, it doesn't even matter. Trash chest. Oh, you can. Okay. That was my question. I'll just save the key in case I... Well, shit. Next time use a key. That's hilarious. Oh, thanks. I had that one coming. For just blindly listening to you. Dude, you seriously got me, like, on edge about this freaking stupid fireplace shit. Alright, well, as you said... Oh, it's a little Isaac. Sorry, Greg, are you bored? That didn't do it? Well, we're almost through the thick of it here. Don't have enough for that. Don't have enough for anything that's really worth it. Do you guys buy armor? Is armor worth it? I hope you filled out a change.org. What do I give this dude? Oh, I don't want to waste my awesome single action army. Unless he's gonna give me something, like, super worthwhile. I've had this game burn me already on that stuff. Like, I don't understand that whole... deceiving, I guess. I would have loved some ammo, though, that's for sure. I think I can... Oh! Cool. This is the one boss that I was able to beat. It has, like, a... I feel like he is definitely a good beginner boss. But I also had poison bullets at the time. Gatling Gull. Oh, why did I do that? Oh, I'm stuck! I just let myself get wrecked, guys. Yes. Fun session with you guys. I am absolutely gonna have to stop at this point. I can't even. I played for a whole freaking hour. It's crazy. It was a lot of fun. And I will continue to play this game. I'll probably play this again. If I stream tomorrow, I'll probably be playing this. I'll just keep cycling through some new characters. If you guys are bored of me doing this, let me know. I can come up with another game. I don't have a lot on my archive, as I declared yesterday and the day before. Still working on building up my stuff, but even though these games are only like Enter the Gungeon is only $15. If you liked what you saw, absolutely buy this game. This is such a cool freaking game. But it adds up so quickly. There's so many games like this that are all perfect little indies, and that's what I want to focus on this morning show is doing some indies. I think they need a little bit more love in general. You guys love AAA titles. I haven't seen a AAA game that I've wanted in a while. Unless you're counting Nintendo, but they're not even in the same class as video game anymore. But their style is what caters to me. So yeah, this has been Morning Glory. I am your host, Ben, once again. Thank you for joining. Hope you have a good day at work if you're working. If you have a day off, kudos to you.